Hey, well, this is what we're gossiping about. Ioan Gruffudd is here. We're going to talk about a really exciting new show. But fellow Welshman, when Matthew Rhys won the Emmy for The Americans, did you feel this finally gave Wales its due?
Well, it was just another feather in our cap, I think. No, I was very proud of him. We grew up together. We went to the same junior school, high school, college.
Oh, wow.
We lived together for 11 years.
Oh, my gosh.
Best man at my wedding. So I was very, very excited for him, very proud.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, amazing and well-deserved.
Are you mystified, and you've done it yourself, when people from elsewhere can play Americans better than we can do it?
He has an exceptional American accent, as do a lot of us British actors. It kind of blows me away as well. But it's, look, we grew up on an American culture as much as our own culture over there. So, you know, we've grown up on television and film since we were born.
And here's the thing, these TV series are these passports now. So this new show we're going to talk about is called Harrow. You shot it in Australia.
Mm-hmm.
It's aired in Australia. It's aired in the UK.
Yes.
It's now on Hulu here. We'll talk about that in a second. What about, does good just travel?
Well, I think this is just a unique look at this genre of the procedural sort of forensic pathologist show. But it's unique because it's shot in Brisbane, Australia. It's quintessentially Australian show. I'm the only sort of British person in the show. And it has that unique flavour that you could only have in a place like Brisbane. For example, we have a body that's discovered inside a crocodile.
As it should be.
And of course, my character has an aversion towards crocodiles. So, you know, there's the conflict there in that episode, you know, having to go and fish out this dead body.
Some people suggest that one reason why, you know, from the BBC going forward, these shows are better is because the orders are shorter. That to do, you know, the typical American television, these 22 episodes, that kind of thing.
I mean, hats off to, you know, showrunners and creators over here who can create 22 episodes and keep us sort of... And I think we've become probably less, more impatient, I think, as audiences, because we like to sit at home and binge watch things. And who has 22 hours in a weekend, you know, where 10 perhaps we could stretch to, you know. But no, this is wonderful. We do have a serialized element to our show as much as we have the procedural element week in, week out. There's a new case. And this one is quite interesting because it's something from Harrow's past that's come back to haunt him. And
even
so, instead of sort of revealing the truth about a dead body, he wants to bury the truth about this dead body.
Well, sold. Watch this. Take a look.
Look, Olivia Reimers is a diagnosed manic depressive whose cause of death fairly determined was brain injury. Fairly signed off on it. I signed off on Fairly, and I am not reopening this case.
I'm not asking you to.
Well, what are you asking?
You're right. Olivia Reimers is a closed case, so her remains are no longer state's evidence. There are 3 days until Reimers claims her or the state cremates. So let me have those 3 days. I have a father's permission to re-examine the body. I just need yours.
Look, on Friday, I get to spend time with my daughter. Reimers will never get that again. He just wants to know he didn't miss anything.
So then are you in a room with the actual body?
I am indeed, yes. And these actors are incredible that come in and play and represent these dead bodies.
They don't move.
They don't move.
They don't breathe.
We ask them not to breathe, you know, and then, of course, we will do a bit of CGI afterwards.
Right. So
should we see them moving? But, and oftentimes you'll be doing a take, of course, and you'll hear sort of a... they're lying there all day long.
Have you encountered other theatrical dead bodies in UK and America? What I'm trying to get at, do you find the people who play dead best are Aussies, English, or American?
Well, the Brits are exceptional. Yeah, everything, let's be honest.
They do everything well.
Yeah.
Whole first season of Harrow is dropped now on Hulu. We'll see you again soon.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Good to see you.